In this video, I'll show you how to set up your Canvas grades for on-campus classes, where you just want to use Canvas for posting grades to students, but that the assignments themselves are getting submitted in class. It is so very tempting to click over to the grades tool and to spend time looking for that create column button, but instead of going to grades, go to assignments. By publishing graded assignments, you will create columns in the grades tool. So, when you're working on setting up your grades in Canvas, plan on spending time in this assignments tool. In this example, it's also handy to have your grade breakdown close by. So, in this example, I'll have 8 quizzes at 10 points, 5 discussions at 20 points, 3 projects, etc., for a total of 270 points in my class. And you can see the letter grade breakdown that we're going to be creating here as well. So, to keep things nice and organized, you're going to want to create assignment groups in Canvas, and it creates one already built in for you called assignments. I'm going to create 3 instead that are called quizzes, discussions, and projects to correspond to the 3 kinds of assignments that I have in my class. I'm going to rename this one by using the options button and edit, and I'll call this one quizzes. And then we'll do add a group for discussions, and I'll add another group for projects. I haven't created the assignments themselves. These are just the buckets where those assignments are going to be found. Time to create the assignments. So I'm going to hit the Add Assignment button once I'm ready to add the assignments. This is the part that's actually going to create that column. So this is a Chapter 1 quiz assignment. This is something that they're completing in class. But I give it a point value, 10 points. I'm going to give it my assignment group. It's going to go into quizzes. Here's the submission type on paper. So that's where they won't be able to submit this in Canvas. They'll be giving this as a in class to me on paper. So I'm going to hit that and save and publish. So I gave it a title, I gave it points, and I said set it to be on paper. If I go back to assignments, I should see that Chapter 1 quiz is now in my quizzes tool. Same thing, I'm going to go ahead and do that again for the Chapter 2 quiz. Set it up exactly the same. Chapter 2 quiz, 10 points, quizzes on paper. Save and publish. And then I'm going to do this 8 times, or 6 more times, to get columns for all 8 of my chapter quizzes. So hang tight while I finish those ones. Okay, so I've gone ahead and created those 8 chapter quizzes, each of them at 10 points. These are all on paper assignments, meaning that my students are going to be completing these quizzes in class. I'm just creating a column for them so I can post their grades. Now I need to do the same thing for discussions and projects. Before I do that, we can double check by going over to grades that we now see columns for each of those chapter quizzes. And sure enough, we do. So now I'd have a place to go in and record grades for my students. So let's head back to assignments and finish building out the rest of the columns on the assignments page. In order to add that discussion, I'm going to click on the Add Assignment button. And this is going to be discussion 1. So this is something that we're having an in-class discussion. They're getting 20 points for it. And for assignment group, the only difference now is that I'm changing that to be discussions. It's still on paper. It's something that they're going to be doing in class. In fact, maybe there's no submission at all. I just want a column for it in the Grade Center. And I'm going to hit save and publish. So this is a discussion that we're having in class. If I go back to assignments, now I have discussion 1 in there. Do the same thing for discussions 2 through 5. Notice I used that plus sign because I knew I wanted to add it to the discussions assignment group. I also can just go back to the assignment, discussion 3. It's 20 discussions and no submission. Save and publish. And then I've got 2 more discussions to do. Well, I'll pause while I complete those. All right, those are complete. So I would have 5 more columns in the Grade Center for those. But while I'm here, I'm going to go ahead and add three more for projects. So now in my projects group, I'm going to hit the add button, call this project one, and these are 30 points each. So I'll pause and be back once I've created those. Okay, I have finished creating all of my assignments in the assignments tool. So I should be able to go to grades and see a column for each of those. I've got my chapter quizzes, there's my discussions to five, and there's my projects one, two, three. And this is a nice place to spot check to the points that you've assigned to each of those. So now, once you're ready to start grading, you will come to the grades tool. You'll see a list of all of your students here. In this demo course, I only have the test student. But you basically click on the little hyphen in order to input the grade that you want to input. That will just give you the option to do the numerical value. If you want to add comments as well, you can click in the little corner. My favorite is to go to the SpeedGrader. Click on that link to the SpeedGrader, and it gives you the option to do a numeric as well as a text comment in here. So you can add that and submit that to your student as well. So where do students see the grades and the comments? If we go back to our grades tool, there we'll see the grade that I just input for test student. Make sure that you use that test student. So on home, you can go to student view, and now we're seeing the course as that test student. The test student sees, and all students will see their grades on the grades tool. I have an indication that there are two new grades in the grades tool. And here's how I can see now my chapter one quiz score as well as my chapter two quiz score, which has a comment in there as well. So that's how students are seeing the grades. No need to open up that assignments tool to students as well. Let's leave student view. Notice on the total that it's summing up the points for me. So it's kind of handy here. It shows me as I hover my mouse over it that this is 18 out of 20. So that's where it's coming up with the 90%. If this student were to miss the chapter three quiz, I would need to go in here and put zero for that student, which is going to now increase the denominator. Now my denominator is 18 over 30, and so their percentage has gone down quite a bit. So it's automatically coming up with the total points for me and determining based on that percentage what letter grade to give it. If you're not seeing that letter grade show up and you want it to, then you can go into the settings and in course details, you'll want to check the box that says Enable Course Grading Scheme. Inside the Course Grading Scheme link, you have the option to select another scheme if the one that you're finding isn't the one you want. That standard scheme, use this grading standard, gives the standard 90, 80, 70, 60. So that's where you enable the letter grades for the grades tool. While I'm here, I want to see if I can get this guy's grade up a little bit higher. Oops. We got him up to a C. Okay, so that was a video on how to set up your Canvas grades for on-campus classes where you just are using Canvas to post grades to students. The key is really to create assignments in the assignments tool. By creating published graded assignments, that's how you'll create columns in the grades tool. Thanks for watching.